Okay, good morning, everyone. All right. Final day of LFW, and we got to see some beautiful, fantastic collections by both Ridhi Mehra and Arpita Mehta. We love the collection because finally we're getting into the whole festive bridal fever that is for the season. I'd love to hear from you, Ridhi, because your collection was inspired, I believe, by Islamic domes and architecture. So would love to hear from you about what the collection was called and what inspired you to create this fantastic presentation for LFW this season.
Hi, everyone. Ridhi here. So my collection is called Adorn, and it has been inspired from the interiors of domes. And we've tried to keep maintain the traditional aspect of our brand, and we've tried to revolve Indian wear for brides and bridesmaids for their special occasions. This year, we've experimented with prints. I would rather say we've developed prints which have been inspired by domes. And besides that, a very interesting element from our collection has been embroidered strips, which we've played with in a very different way. So we've used weaving, we've used tasseling with embroidered strips. Besides that, we've also done tassels, we've done fringes, we've done feathers, which have been trending globally. And we've incorporated zardozi with laser cut leather. We've also used a lot of interesting fabrics this time. We've used suede, we've used pashmina, which is different, which is something that I've not done before. And I'm sure the rest you must have anywhere seen on the ramp.
Really was a beautiful collection. Malaika, you look ultra, ultra glamorous. I'd love to hear from you. How was it like walking for a dear friend that is Ridhi?
Firstly, good morning, everybody. This is the first time I'm walking for Ridhi, and normally, I don't know, for some reason, year after year after year, everybody always puts me in Indian wear, including Arpita. I've walked for Arpita in the past, so... Somehow, you know, it's always either fusion or Indian. So this is the first time I'm actually wearing something completely on a Western silhouette and tassels, which I really love. Every time you move, it kind of gives you that extra fun edge. So I'm really glad that I could do something different this year. And I love the color red. So thank you for that, Ridhi. And I think we all had a really good time. And thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Arpita, your collection was extremely sensuous. It was perfect in terms of the festive fever that we're talking about right now. I'd love to hear from you because I believe your collection was called Midnight Muse. So what inspired you to create this? I mean, for this time around for LFW.
So the collection is titled Midnight Muse, and that was derived because it's something that I believe in. Like every woman, every lady has a sensuous and bold, confident side to herself. And it's kind of an inspiration, or it's more like a thing that which inspired me to make this line, because it's kind of, sorry about that. So it's inspired by that side of the lady, and which is very confident, very strong. So while the silhouettes are flowy with high slits and lot of layering, the jackets are structured. So it's like a combination of sensuality as well as confidence. So that is what the collection is all about.
Kriti, you look like a red carpet diva as always. So considering this is such a festive and sensuous collection, could you let us know what it was like walking for Arpita?
It's always amazing, I think, for me to come back to the ramp. And when you're wearing something as beautiful as what Arpita has made for me, you know, it just becomes more fun. And you feel like a diva, I feel. And I just love the outfit. I like the fact that, you know, it's ethnic, but at the same time, it's very contemporary and it's modern. It's feminine, but still very structured. I love the dramatic drapes that she's given me on this. A lot of drapes. It doesn't give a feel of a dupatta, but it's still, you know, some modern bit of a dupatta that's there. And I had a lot of fun, yeah. I think, yeah. Yeah, which he specially did for this outfit. Thank you for that. It's got these 3D mirrorwork birds, which obviously you can't see because I'm sitting right now. But I had a lot of fun. I think I was watching her collection backstage also. I think, you know, I really like the structured jackets. I like that slightly Indo-Western element to it. There are some completely Western outfits also, which also are very young and very feminine. I think she rocked, and her whole collection is something that I look out for.
It was a beautiful collection all in all. Both the designers did complete justice to the collection and their muse.
Thank you
so much to you all. You. Just opening the floor to media if they have any questions.
Said it all, no?
Yeah,
it was all out there.
No questions.
Very detailed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a question. So, showstoppers, when you get the outfit, what do you have in mind, you know, when you're wearing the outfit, is it something different that you want to walk? It's a different style. Like, you have tassels, Malaika. So, do you want to play around with these tassels? I mean, what are the thoughts that cross your mind?
The first thought that crosses your mind is, I hope I'm not looking out of shape or anything in whatever you wear. That's the first thing that, I hope I'm looking all fine. But yeah, I think with every outfit that you wear, you always find that one element that makes you, that makes you feel bold, that makes you feel confident, and you want to, and I think every outfit dictates the mood of how you need to be on ramp. If it's sensuous, then automatically you are. If it's fun, if it's flirty, if it's edgy. I think the outfit dictates all of that. And yes, I did have all these tassels on it, so it kind of made me want to, shimmy and shake over there, because that's how it felt. So yeah, I like that. I think it just kind of brought out a little bit of a fun element in it.
I think, yeah, firstly, I mean, you do see how the outfit is looking on you, if it's complementing your body type and all. But apart from that, you do find these small things, to play along with. But at the same time, you have to be careful. Like, for example, the drapes. She has warned me backstage some 10 times that don't step on your own drape, okay? So I had to make sure that while I was moving the drape also along. So there's a little bit of in front of the mirror posing, seeing how the outfit can look its best. But that's about it. It's about having fun at the end of it. It's always very nice. Yeah, when I come back, the backstage, like I meet so many people who I've known for a very long time. And it's fun to just talk to them and gel with them again. But at the same time, somebody just asked me, in between like 2-3 designers when there are changes. So somebody just asked me, do you miss the madness? And I was like, no, this is the only part I don't miss. Because it was stressful when you had to just... I used to hate it when I had changes in a show because you have to really run. You can trip on your own clothes while running. But that kick that you get when you're about to enter the ramp and when you're on it for these just 20 seconds, which feels so long at some time, I think that is the same. It just feels the same.
My all-time, I guess it depends on the festival, right? I mean, it depends on this. But I think for me, I'd love a sari. So I think that would be unanimous any festival, any time of the year, I'd choose a sari.
I think, it depends on the festival completely. I love saris. I also like anarkalis and sometimes just like a crop top and a skirt, which gives a feeling of a lehenga, but it's not a lehenga. Similar to something that I'm wearing right now, actually. But I think it can vary. Like, I even like anarkalis. So.
What's your fashion statement?
Fashion statement? It keeps changing, yeah. Fashion is never, it's never constant. And I think it changes with the new trends that come in. It also changes with your change of taste and how you evolve as a person. So, it's definitely comfort that always gets the priority.
I don't really have a fashion statement. I think I just go with the flow, whatever I feel comfortable in, whatever I think I look good in. I don't really believe in following trends or following. But yes, you have to keep abreast of what's happening. I mean, because I guess we're all in the business, so we need to know that. But for me, I think it's just about being comfortable.
So I just feel that you're always focusing on your garments, on your shows, and making sure the models look amazing. But the minute you have someone who you know as well, it's not that we have someone who we don't know, someone who you know you've worked with in the past, and having them come onto the stage and do this elaborate walk for you, I think it just adds on to your show. So I think it's a good touch. It takes it to the next level, and it makes it much more exciting, even for me as a designer, and I'm sure even for the viewers.
I second the same. I totally think what Arpita is saying is right. And also, I feel it, like, as she said, as a designer, it adds more excitement to you. And I feel for the show as well, like, for the people who are coming to see the show, they're quite excited.
So Kriti is wearing this elaborate lehenga. It has a lot of thread work, these mirror work birds, which are like a 3D applique, and she's wearing this really tiny choli. So as per Indian sensibilities, of course, you are expected to wear a dupatta or something, you know. So the point was to change it up a bit, give it a bit of a modern twist. So we added these drapes, which are already attached to her blouse right from the back. And to add more glamour, we gave her like a ruffled dupatta, which just adds on to more drama. So it's kind of making it a little more modern than what a regular lehenga is.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Just a request, if we could have you in the front for a couple of pictures.
This is a janta wear, right?
Yeah.
Guys, full silence. Can't hear yourself.
Yeah, I can't hear anything.
बरेली की बर्फी का स्वाद लोगों को बहुत भा रहा है बहुत मिठास है आपको यहां आने पे आपके चेहरे पे कितनी मिठास है उसको शेक की लोग पसंद कर रहे हैं और
आपको दिख रही होगी मिठास आई थिंक हां आई एम वेरी वेरी हैप्पी विद द रिस्पांस चाहे आप रिव्यूज की बात करें या फिर जो ऑडियंस देखने जा रही है वो जिस तरह से रिस्पोंड कर रही है आई एम रीडिंग ईच एंड एवरी ट्वीट ऑफ पीपल हु आर कमिंग आउट ऑफ द थिएटर एंड दे आर रियली एंजॉयिंग इट सो आई एम हैप्पी दैट दे आर रिलिशिंग द बरेली की बर्फी एंड इट्स गेटिंग इट्स ड्यू
और रैंप पे आपने जो आउटफिट पहना है
जी
उसमें क्या खास है और आपके डिजाइनर आपको खूबसूरत बनाने में उसमें खास और कितनी शुगर फ्री
ये ऑलरेडी खूबसूरत
है ऑलरेडी इतने ब्यूटीफुल है आई थिंक ये बहुत ये एथनिक लहंगा है पर एट द सेम टाइम बहुत मॉडर्न फील है इसमें जैसा कि आप ड्रेप्स देख रहे हैं वो दुपट्टे की जगह ड्रेप्स हैं इवन ब्लाउज से पीछे ड्रेप्स जा रहे हैं नीचे विच एड टू द ड्रामा एंड ये स्पेशली इन्होंने मेरे लिए ये 3D मिरर वर्क बर्ड्स जो हैं वो इस लहंगे में डाली हैं मिरर वर्क इज़ समथिंग दैट शी इज़ बीन डूइंग इन हर प्रीवियस कलेक्शंस ऑल्सो बट शी शिफ्टेड इट ऑलमोस्ट टू लाइक थ्रेड वर्क इन दिस टाइम बट दीज आर दीज लिटल एलिमेंट्स आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट एम्प्लीफाइज द आउटफिट एंड मेक्स इट सो ब्यूटिफुल
Why a long chain, you know, I mean, because these days, if you see the trend, it's more about, you know, short.
It's short
yeah,
and long,
so
if you see.
Yeah, so basically, the trend is always to go really dressy on the choker as well as wear a long hair, but because we were trying to make it a bit modern, so we thought of stacking these slimmer necklaces, keep it short and long, so that it has a good modern feel.
What is your take on this?
I loved it. I think you know, it's with jewelry. It's always you know after you wear the outfit, you try and put it and what's looking good and what's not. And I when she put these two, it was looking very nice. And I think this long chain just added an element to the outfit. It just made it a little more modern.
So what is your you know jewelry wardrobe like?
My jewelry wardrobe is messy. I have to find jewelry when I open that wardrobe. But I think I like it lightweight. I like it sometimes chunky when it comes to neck pieces. I have a few chokers as well. I love ear cuffs. And otherwise, I think, you know, mix and match of modern and ethnic kind of jewelry is what I like.
So did you see the collection? I mean, what are the takeaways from her collection?
I think I loved it. I loved it. I loved each and every piece that was coming there. I liked the fact that, you know, it was very feminine, but at the same time, there was a structure to it. I loved the structured jackets. There were these crop tops and, you know, culottes and also, and layered skirts also, which I think, you know, I think they're fun, they're young, and they're very chic.
So do you put a lot of effort for your airport looks?
No, airport looks, my first thing that comes to my mind is it has to be comfortable. I can't sit on a long flight, especially wearing something that I'm not comfortable in. So it has to be relaxed. It has to be not done. But at the same time, you know, you like stepping out feeling stylish. So that's about it.
Latest fashion experiment.
Last question.
Fashion experiment. I think I like the crop top. Skirt, lehenga skirt kind of a feel. I like it when it's not completely ethnic or not completely modern. It's somewhere in between. I think I love boho kind of looks. I've done a lot of them, in fact, recently for my promotions. And I think if it's a nice Indian function, something like this is very young. You know, it feels young. It's not like a regular lehenga or an anarkali.
Actually, जब ही मैंने first time कृति को पहले model के तरीके में देखा था, after that I saw her come in a movie, and since then it's like I've had a girl crush on Kriti, and she's so gorgeous, she's beautiful, she's confident, but she still has that innocence that makes you just want her to just wear all your clothes, be it lehengas or be it crop tops, anything at all. She pulls it off with utmost ease.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.